The sound you're hearing in the background is a loop of tape. A loop approximately 8 inches in perimeter, recorded at 7.5 inches a second, spliced end to end, going through a tape recorder. The purpose of this little tape demonstration is to give an idea of the overall evolution of my particular approach to synthetic rhythms. I showed you just a moment ago what a short loop of tape sounds like in a loop. Now I'm going to play one with a longer interval, a longer piece of tape. The instruments that I make these loops on are a pair of Indian tabla, one of which I have here. Actually, striking the drum in this way doesn't give anywhere near the overall range of sounds which I can get from this drum by using various techniques with a recorder. Now I'm going to add a single note on this same drum, this one that goes so, and show you how we can change the rhythm slightly, give a very strange sound from this drum. That popping sound that you hear was created with this small Indian tabla. Another instrument I use is a Haitian conga drum. The variation in sounds with this drum you'll notice that we got two distinct sounds out of the conga drum by striking the drum as we started the tape mechanism rolling, at which time it's traveling at a slower speed than normal. Therefore, the sound covers a smaller area of the tape and raises itself in pitch. So these drums are capable of providing quite a few different sounds. I use a few bells. I use vocal sounds, and I'll give a demonstration of vocal sounds. This technique, incidentally, requires at least two tape recorders, one to make loops on and play them back while you record them onto a regular magnetic tape. So we'll start with Sonata for Loudspeaker, which used some of the aforementioned instruments as well as vocal sounds. was Sonata for Loudspeaker in Three Parts, using a variety of drums and vocal sounds. The next step after this was to work primarily on percussion and rhythm, and to find out what I could about the characteristics of rhythm. I'm going to play another early experiment. The next step, really, which occupied me for another 5 months or so, was working with two rhythms simultaneously, and I managed to do this by using a binaural tape recorder, recording one constant rhythm on one channel and variations on another. Rhythms are played on two tape recorders, and instead of using contrasting sounds as in the earlier compositions, the same basic sound pattern is used. And for example, one measure or a cycle of it is contrasted with a distorted two, two and a half, three, three and a half, or four cycle. The rhythm is constantly changing. You get the kind of same asymmetrical pattern that you get in African rhythms. Here's a short thing that exploited mostly vocal sounds. You've been listening to a tape demonstration of a group of experiments in synthetic rhythm, which I was doing in 1953 and 1954.